Hello everyone, as yesterday we had attended some question in which logarithm and exponents were given and we proceed for the derivative of a given form. Now next point we are going to discuss is if your function is written as a product form, means more than two functions are written in a product form, or your term is written in terms of the power and the power itself is available in the variable form. So at that time, to write the differentiation of given term, we will use this logarithm differentiation. So this is the new method we have to introduce. So let's try to understand what the method is and how it can be implemented. Now there are two ways or there are two situations in which this method can be implemented. First of all, suppose if y is written as this form, ux means the base is available in terms of x and the power of this term is also available in terms of x. So at that time we will use the log method. How it is to be implemented? Both the side you take the log. So on both the side logarithm is to be taken, and here what the log we are going to take, it will be with base e. So this is log y. Here as a power of this term is available as vx, so on taking the logarithm, this power will come at first position followed by log of the base. Now this combination we will proceed for further differentiation. Now one more form it can be available in the question. At that time also log can be implemented. If your y is written as a multiple of more than two functions, suppose these three terms are written in a product form, so product rule also it can be implemented, and for more conveniency log also you can take. So here also if you are going to take logarithm on both the side, in general we are writing here, then particular one we will discuss as a solution of given quotient form. Now here you can implement the property of product along with the log, so each term will get separate in addition form. Now both the side can be treated for differentiation. So this way, if more terms are written as a product form, log method you can implement. So in order to that, look at some question from the exercise 5.5, so we will be more clear that in which situation this method can be implemented and how it can be sought out. Now we look at the first question of exercise 5.5. In first question, your question is available as a product of cos terms, cos of x, cos of 2x and cos of 3x. Here we are going to implement logarithm method to given terms. Product rule also here it can be implemented, and log form also it can be implemented. Now taking log on both sides, so this will be your log of y. Here log to the full combination, log of x, log of 2x, log of 3x. Implement your log product rule. Log cos of x, each term will be separated and write in a additive form. Now each terms are available for differentiation, so now we can proceed for differentiation on both the side. So now differentiate with respect to x. First of all, left hand side derivation, log of y, so as a log term, differentiation of this term will be 1 upon y. As we are considering the y term, so along with that dy by dx writing is compulsory. Here all terms are with the x, so direct we can proceed for differentiation. First of all, regarding this log cos of x, so it will be 1 upon cos of x. First of all, with respect to the log form, and then as a chain rule, differentiation of cos, that is your minus sine of x. Move to the next. This is again, implement the chain rule. First of all, with respect to this log, you will write the derivation. So it will be your 1 upon cos of 2x. Now, differentiation of cos 2x, it will be your minus sine 2x into 2. This 2x is present, that's why this 2 will also become derivation of x, it will be 1. So here we have not written anything. Next to that, again with respect to your log, it will be 1 upon cos of 3x, derivation of cos minus sine of 3x into this 3. So this way, this derivation form we are having. Now try to combine the respective terms. So this is 1 upon y as such minus sine upon cos with the same angle. So it will be turned as a tan of x minus this 2 constant we will write at the first position. Sine 2x upon cos 2x will turn as tan 2x minus 3 constant at the first position. Sine 3x upon cos 3x will turn as tan of 3x. Still we are not up to the final form. Dy by dx is to be separate out. Here 1 by y is written as a multiple form. So this y we have to multiply over here. So your dy by dx will be separate out as a y. Even minus you can take common among these all. So this is tan of x plus 2, tan of 2x plus 3, tan of 3x. Always answer should be in terms of x. So y means what the question it was, here we have to copy. So finally, this will be your minus cos of x, cos of 2x, cos of 3x, and the whole combination as such is to be copy out. 10x, 2 tan of 2x plus 3 tan of 3x. So this way logarithm you can implement to a given question form. So this is a one form where logarithm method you have to implement. Next we look at one more form in which you can implement the log. Now the next is your question number second of the same exercise. Another form we are having, y is equal to square root of x minus 1, x minus 2, x minus 3, x minus 4 and x minus 5. You can look at this combination. This whole combination containing power half, and terms are also written in form of the factor f by g form. So here direct, first of all we will implement the log. Under root means this term containing power half. So logarithm we will take here, taking log on both sides, log of y. Here first of all, as such we will write x minus 1, x minus 2, x minus 3, x minus 4, x minus 5. This expression containing power half. The square root I have written as a half power. Now, as per the log rule, this half will come at the first position. So, secondly, This half you can write here, followed by the log form. Now here, again implement the log form as a m by n. So these two factors are to be treated as a m. These three factors are to be treated as n. So here no change. 1 upon 2 log of, or direct, if you can handle the situation, you can write the direct form also. Minus this three combination are to be write with negative sign as it is in the denominator position. Now further, each term are to be separate out as a additive form. Log of x minus 1 plus log of x minus 2. Here minus, each term separate out, now here each log term will multiply with the negative sign, so make each term separate with the respective signs. Minus x minus 3 minus x minus 4 minus x minus 5. Now you are at the position, after then you can write the derivative. So now we will proceed for differentiation on both the side. So differentiation with respect to x. Before writing the derivative, you make sure that you are in this position, that each term can be handled separately for writing derivation. Now, left hand side differentiation, 1 upon y divided by dx. Right hand side 1 by 2 you keep outside. With respect to log, it will be your 1 upon x minus 1, 1 upon x minus 2 minus 1 upon x minus 3 minus 1 upon x minus 4 minus 1 upon x minus 5. Now dy by dx is to be separate out, so y is to be multiplied over here. So further, dy by dx you make separate, y upon 2, 1 upon x minus 1 plus 1 upon x minus 2 minus 5. What the y we were having in the beginning, it is to be substituted here. Final answer should be in terms of x, compulsory. So here in place of y we will write the question form. It is 1 upon 2 x minus 1 x minus 2 x minus 3 x minus 4 x minus 5 with power half, and this whole expression you will write as such: 1 upon x minus 1 plus 1 upon x minus 2 minus 1 upon x minus 3 minus 1 upon x minus 4 minus 1 upon x minus 5. So this way, this type of situation we have to handle. So if your questions are bulky, long expressions are available, so to make them solve, we have to implement logarithm form. In order to that, we just look at some more combinations. Now in next form, we are having question number form, in which you can see these two terms are written in a separate form with the certain power of a function of x. So this type of question directly we can't proceed for taking logarithm. So here in such type of different combination, first of all we have to convert the question in somewhat form. U and v, separate functions we have to define. So now it is to be write a differentiation with respect to x now. So differentiation with respect to x. So first of all we derive here the standard form what we required as answer, and then we will go for separate derivation. So here dy by dx, du by dx plus dv by dx. Now this is became our standard form where we have to write derivation of your u function. U function means the function at the first position. Derivation of the v function means function at the second position. Now these two we are going to handle separately. So first of all, this u we will write as x power x. Here you can see this base is available with x, power is also available with x. So at this position we will go for taking logarithm. So taking log. So log of u is equal to log of x power x. Implement your log power property. This will be x log of x. Now both the side proceed for writing differentiation with respect to x. So differentiation with respect to x, this will be your 1 upon u du by dx. Here product rule it will be implement. So first of all we write derivation of x and keeping log of x as a first position plus, now x we are keeping at the first position, and proceed for derivation of log of x. Now write the respective derivation. This is to be write as such. Differentiation of x is 1, and direct also you can write it as 1 plus derivation of this log x is 1 by x, so x upon x. This xx will cut, and finally you will left with a 1. So here 1 upon u du by dx, that you will have as log of x plus 1. Now this du by dx we have to separate out. So du by dx, that is u log of x plus 1. What the u it was, that is to be substituted. So finally du by dx will be separate out as x power x log of x plus 1. Here one more form it can be written with this log combination, that is x power x, this log x, this is nothing, log e. These two can be combined, and this is the shortest form you can write as x and e. So either you write this form or this form, both are the same. Now move to the second term, that is v minus 2 sine of x. Here this minus you can consider as a product form. So here go for taking the logarithm here, or it is better to write a without minus. Here you will include the minus sign. So here you can make a change. In place of plus you can write minus for more conveniency. So this minus will not interfere on taking logarithm. So now take log log of v log of 2 sine of x log of v sine of x into log of 2. This term even direct you can treat as a power x form. Now differentiation on both the side. वन अपॉन वी डी वी बाई डी एक्स, लॉग टू इज बींग कॉन्स्टेंट, डिफ्रेंशिएशन ऑफ साइन इज कॉस, डी वी बाई डी एक्स इज टू बी सेपरेट आउट, वी विल मल्टीप्लाई हियर, दैट इज कॉस ऑफ एक्स इंटू लॉग ऑफ टी. वॉट द वी इट वॉज इन द बिगिनिंग यू राइट ओवर हियर, सो इट विल बी टू पावर साइन ऑफ एक्स इंटू कॉस ऑफ एक्स इंटू लॉग ऑफ टू. नाउ दीज टू वी हैव सेपरेट आउट इन टर्म्स ऑफ डेरिवेशन. सो नाउ वी कम टू द फाइनल आंसर फॉर्म. हियर डी यू बाई डी एक्स यू विल राइट, हियर डी वी बाई डी एक्स यू विल राइट. नाउ फाइनल आंसर फॉर्म डी वाई बाई डी एक्स यू आर हैविंग एस एनी ऑफ द फॉर्म यू कैन राइट हियर, एक्स पावर एक्स लॉग ऑफ एक्स ई प्लस टू साइन ऑफ एक्स इंटू कॉस ऑफ एक्स इंटू लॉग ऑफ टू. सो दिस वे योर फाइनल आंसर विल कम आउट. सो एट लास्ट वॉट द सेपरेट डिफ्रेंशिएशन यू हैव रिटर्न विथ प्लस और माइनस साइन यू कैन राइट एट द फाइनल स्टेज. सो इफ योर टर्म्स आर रिटर्न विद द सेपरेट फॉर्म with the distinct combination, this way you have to make it suppose as a distinct one and then proceed for the individual derivation. Now with respect to this x power x form, one form I would like to introduce here, somewhere you will find the combination as sine. This way you may have some combinations. If you look at these two forms, it seems that both are same, but in reality both are distinct one. Here this is to be supposed as u, this is to be supposed as v. Again separately we will go for writing the differentiation. So what the change in the differentiation you try to understand. First case, if you deal u as a sin x with power x, meaning of this term is a whole power of this sin x is power x. So here log you can implement on both the side, so it will be log u x log of sin x, and accordingly it is to be treated. Differentiation we write, so differentiation of x is 1, so log sin x we will write here, direct I am writing, plus x log of sin x means 1 upon sin x, and of sin x it is cos of x. So finally your du by dx will be separate out as u into log of sin x plus x cot of x. Here you will write what it was in the beginning, sin x with power x, and this is to be write as such. Now come to the second case, that is an important part of this question. Here we are going to suppose as sin x power x. Here this x power is written as a angle form. So in this case it is not possible to take logarithm and make this power separate. So as such we will proceed for differentiation here without taking log. So it will be dv by dx. Chain rule here it will be implemented. So differentiation with respect to this sign is cos, and further as an angle differentiation of x power x we have to write, and for this differentiation again we will use the third variable to make it differentiate on taking the logarithm, as in the previous case we have seen derivative of this term, it was x power x log x e. So many time it is to be used. So here this x power x you are going to suppose as a t, further taking logarithm, find out its a derivative and write over here. So the same thing we have already attended in the last case. So direct here I am writing the derivation what we have written just now. So this way, if only the position of the power is being changed, your method is to be changed. This is very important for many times students are getting confused in this form and this form. So if whole power is x, at that time you can implement the logarithm. If your angle is written with this power x, so separately it is to be write as a derivative form. So in next class we will discuss a more question based on this category.